Hello, everyone. I'm Joy Banfield, AccuQuilt's Chief of Staff, and welcome to today's relaunch party for the Go Crossroads die. We released this die in August as part of our Die to Try program, and this program allows us to reveal a new die each month that's only available for a limited time, and once the die is out of stock, you're then able to vote for it to be added to our permanent collection, and you decided that the Go Crossroads die should be one of them.
Yeah, congratulations. Yay. Thanks for voting.
We have some great inspiration for you in the relaunch of this very versatile block on board die. Plus, we've got some other exciting things to tell you. So let's get into the show. Here are your quilting adventure guides, Pam and Erica.
Hello, thank you, Miss Joy. Thanks for joining us.
Nice to have you here.
My pleasure.
All right, quilters, the Crossroads quilt block is so easy and fun to make. Oh. And I think, Joy, you have a little sneak peek of something you made.
She's been playing with it.
Yes.
Yeah, it really is fun. I love how you can take this traditional block, give it a modern look, and I love what you've done with it.
Yeah.
Well, I can't wait to show you. It's definitely a versatile block, and I've seen some of the projects that our quilting community has made using this die, and you can really see how much fun they've been having with it, too. They've definitely been inspired by how this die it makes cutting fabric fast, easy, accurate, and safe.
Absolutely. All right, quilters, let's get this Go Crossroads party started.
That's right. As always, we've planned a lot of fun for you. We've got some great prizes, exciting project ideas, including Joy's.
Yes.
An inspirational trunk show and special offer only available today.
All right, Pam and Erica, I'll be back later for the trunk show.
Okay,
all right.
Fun.
Okay.
All right, thanks, Miss Joy.
Thank you.
All right, quilters, a little later, we'll be meeting up with two special guests. We have Amanda Harward, who will be telling us about how she created a pattern combining the Go Crossroads die with the Go Cross Canoes die,
yes,
which you and I think is an unsung hero.
It really is. I'm excited to talk about it today.
Yep.
And we're also going to be meeting up with Gina Jempesaw. Now, she'll be talking with us about her design that uses the Go Crossroads die, the 9-inch cube, and the 9-inch cube companion, plus the 2-inch finished half-square triangle. I'm excited to meet up with them. So let's get back on the road again and tell everyone a little bit about this die, Pam.
All right. This die is so much fun. What really is great about it is that it's perfect for quilters of all levels.
Absolutely. This quilt block has so many layout options. And since it's one of our bob dies or block on board dies, it has all the pieces needed to make one block on one die board. Now, this die can be used with all of our Go cutters, which is great.
Yes.
Including the Go Me. Plus, since it finishes at 9 inches, it can be combined with the 9-inch cube as well as other same size block designs and block on board dies.
Excellent. All right, let's take a quick look at it. Get ready to relax and enjoy your next quilting adventure with the Go Crossroads die. This block on board or bob die makes it possible for you to cut all the pieces you need to navigate this 9-inch finished block in just one pass through your cutter. The die features some of AccuQuilt's best innovations, including two-tone foam, screen-printed letters for pieces, and specialized dog ears to make creating this block quick and easy. Cutting the 41 pieces per block by hand would be complicated and time-consuming, but using the Go Bob die makes this journey enjoyable. The 6x24 die board means it's compatible with any of our Go cutters. The Go Crossroad Bob creates a 9-inch finished block that will coordinate with other 9-inch finished Bob blocks and be the perfect companion to the Go Cube Mix and Match 9-inch finished block. Team it up with the Go 9-inch setting triangles to put it on point for a whole new look that's sure to inspire more projects than you could possibly imagine. Quilters are sure to enjoy taking this versatile die on a creative adventure, because at AccuQuilt, we help you cut time so you can quilt more.
All right, quilters, today only, get 30% off your order when you use the code FUN30. Now, Some exceptions apply, so check the website for details. This is a great offer.
It is. And don't forget, for a limited time, we're offering you two special bundles, which are included in that 30% off deal.
Which is amazing.
And quilters, everything right now is in stock and ready to ship today, but there are limited numbers, so don't delay.
That's right.
First up, we have our Go Crossroads Die Bundle. You're gonna get the Go Crossroads Die and a 6x24 cutting mat. Normally, this bundle would cost $109, but purchase it today and you will spend $76.99. That means you're saving over $32. That's pretty impressive.
That's right, that's right. We're also offering our Go Crossroads and Setting Triangle Die Bundle. You want this one, okay? Because you're gonna get the Crossroads die plus the Go Setting Triangles 9-inch finish. Look how cool that block looks.
Yes.
On point. You're gonna get two mats, the 10x24 and the 6x24. Now normally this bundle would cost $252, but by ordering this bundle today with the code, you're only gonna spend $176.37. That means you're saving over $75.
Now, I love those setting triangles.
I do
too. Because it allows you to just set those blocks on point and it gives it such a different
look. Such a different look.
All right. Quilters, we know you don't want to miss a minute of our launch party, but these deals are only available for limited time. So get your orders in today.
That's right. To get your order in during this show, you can use your phone's camera to capture the QR image here. Go right to the bundles.
And if you don't have access to a QR reader, you want to just open a new tab in your browser, go to the top of the page, click on that plus sign. In that very top box, type in accuquilt.com/party. It'll show you the bundles and you can place your order. That way you won't miss a minute of our show.
That's right.
And quilters, we know our dies and fabric cutters are an investment. So AccuQuilt offers fast and easy financing with installments or split pay options. For more information on financing through AccuQuilt, visit accuquilt.com/financing.
That's right. All right. Now quilters, this week is a very special week and it is International Quilt Festival Week in Houston.
Yes.
And in honor of that, Pam and I are going to bring you some very special shows this Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
All
the
days.
Week. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's right. Now listen, quilters. Thursday, we have a sneak peek at a new die. I know, and you'll be able to purchase it on Thursday. A new look at some fabric. Oh, we saw some beautiful fabrics.
Oh, quilters, you don't want to miss this.
Yep. And some quilting all-stars. Be sure to register for each day, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, to get in on the fun and for your chance to win some really fun prizes that we've planned.
Yep.
In fact, we just counted. We have a total of 41 prizes to give away during those three shows. But you can't win unless you register.
That's right. All right, quilters. Now, let's get started with today's show. We are happy to have our good friend Amanda Harward joining us. She's joining us virtually today. Amanda's been designing projects for AccuQuilt for almost 5 years. Now, she started learning to quilt before her children were born and has enjoyed developing her quilting skills. She's always looking forward to the next new technique that she can try. Welcome to the set, Amanda.
Amanda, welcome back.
Hi. Hi, how are you?
Good. We're so glad to have you back on our show with us today. Now, you're here to share your Crossroads quilt called Go Crossing Paths, which is now a pattern available at AccuQuilt.com. So tell us what inspired you about that design.
Well, I love the picture of the design with the circle and everything. And so I decided to play with the color placement and break up the circle and see what happened that way. And it kind of feels like it looks like ropes a little bit, like with the canoes. So.
It does.
Oh, it does.
It does.
All right. So tell us a little bit about your design process and how you actually went about creating this pattern.
So I usually start out with an Electric 8, the computer program, and I like to make everything blank. So I turn it all the colors white, and then I add a little bit of color at a time and see how the blocks interact with each other.
Very clever.
That is a great tip. You know, we sell EQ8 on the website. That is,
watching
it got us. We were like,
blocking your block.
We tend to get very involved.
Yes. And we do sell EQ8 on our website.
Yeah, we do. That's a great tip.
I love that you combine Crossroads and Go Cross Canoes, because Cross Canoes, Eric and I feel like is a real unsung hero in the Bob dies, and we both really like it. And it really creates this fun design. Were there any other Bob dies you considered before deciding on this combo?
Oh, good question.
Yeah.
But when I first looked at it, it kind of looks like the churn dash block with like the straight and then the corners cut off and the like the diagonal lines in the corners. So I looked at that a little bit, but it felt like it was competing. And so I didn't like the end result of that, but yeah.
Yeah.
All right, do you have any pro tips for our quilters that want to make this project?
Yeah, I like when I put the two blocks together. Mm-hmm. So here's the
crossroads
block. Crossroads. And it has, so it's a 9-patch.
Uh-huh.
And then the cross canoes is a 4-patch.
Mm-hmm.
And I really liked it because when you combine them the two, there's less seams to match up in the middle.
Oh, that's very clever.
Yeah, so it's really fun and it goes together really fast when you don't have to worry about that.
That's great.
And I loved, Amanda, how your points all came together perfectly. So I love the way that you use those two dies to create those intersections of points. Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful. It worked out really well. It was kind of a surprise when I put them together.
Isn't that nice?
We like happy surprises.
We do.
Well, your quilt design is wonderful, Amanda. Thanks so much for joining us. We hope to see you again soon.
Thanks for joining us. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, I just love her quilt because, first of all, it's just those three colors, right?
Yeah.
And the way that she just changed
it around.
So it looks a little broken and like rope.
And it did. She did. Her block that she had there really pulled out that churn dash look to it.
Yeah. It makes me want to go home. Every time we say this.
Every time we want to go home and sew. It's amazing we get anything done at all.
Ever.
All right, let's take a closer look at the Go Crossroads die before we go running off to a sewing machine.
Okay, so here is the Crossroads die. Like Erica said, it's on a 6x24 die board. Mm-hmm. It will fit through all of our Go cutters, including a Go Me.
Right.
And we've screen printed the letters for you for easy placement to keep track of your pieces.
Yes.
Now, Erica, when we get to shape D right here, this is, some people think it's like this, a signature block. But actually, there's a blade there, so it's going to make that pentagon shape.
That's right. That's right. And really, the only trick about this is putting these E's the right direction on your D's, and that's not hard at all.
Yeah. And we always going to say to you, make a test block.
Yes.
Right. Now, you can always cut 6 layers of cotton with our dies, but you could cut other fabrics, flannel, felt, denim.
Yeah, whatever you wanted. And we've got, of course, our specialized dog ears, so you're not going to have to do extra trimming. Our quarter inch seam allowances are built in. You're good to go.
Perfect. And B is actually 2 rectangles. So we're going to show you how to do it. So let's lay some fabric out.
Yep, let's take a look.
We have some. Imagine that.
Imagine that. We have fabric.
So the packaging will tell you how to subcut your fabric. So we're just gonna lay some shape here. And I have some ones already cut out. So this one's kind of cool because you need 3 colors for it. Oh, here, look. Here's a block.
Oh, yes, yeah, so we know where we're going. There's our roadmap.
Yeah, so you need 3 colors. So here's my
1, 2, 3 colors.
I wanna cut it the right direction. And then C is this shape right here. Right, so I'm just gonna cut one of those. And here's our little pentagons.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Amanda's is switched so it looks like it's on top.
Yes, it's all about color placement. You can do so much. This die really, it's deceptive how much you can do with it. The more you use it, the more things you're gonna find to do with it.
And it's gonna fit in all of our cutters. We're gonna use our Go Big. How come, Erica?
Because we can.
Right, now the Go Big isn't part of that 30% off, but it's specially priced.
That's right, it has its own special deal. It's $150 off.
Yeah, so if you're looking to buy that gift just for yourself, this is a good one to get.
And like Miss Pam, buy yourself a special gift.
I do. It's my favorite thing.
I love that.
Okay. All right, so now we're gonna give it a little love. Slide our mat, don't lift, because static is here.
Oh, static lives here, yeah.
Yeah,
it sure does.
So look at how fast and easy. Erica, think about how long it would take you to cut those shapes, and they would never be...
They would never be quite perfect.
Yep, so here I have the little step outs in the right color.
And of course, we've got our center block,
yep.
So that's super easy.
Yep, and shall we make one of these corners and show them, because we have fabric for it, okay? So then... These little guys are actually gonna go here. like this. Hang on, see, this is why we practice.
This is why we practice.
Yep. There we go.
Here we go.
There we go. Yep. Oh, and we could put our pentagon shapes here that go the other direction. Mm-hmm. So look at how those dog ears
no,
are.
You don't need those here. This is your corner.
Oh,
this
here,
goes here.
See,
there, that's.
There we go.
There. She can't. We can't do anything with that.
I know.
She can't do anything with that.
There, put those little corners on there.
Those
and
go.
Then look, we color cut three.
This is always my problem with this. Wait.
See?
There
it's
we go.
It's not just me.
Nope.
There we go. There we go. Ta-da, ta-da.
And see, the important thing to note is that these are quarter square triangles. That's so that you've got that lengthwise grain towards the outside of your block. So you don't have a wonky box, so that's always important.
Yep. Okay, so we're gonna always tell you to sew a test block.
Yep.
So that you know how all your pieces go. But look how fast this went together. This is a really great chain piecing block.
Yep, it is.
Because you can just make all of these sections together and all of the other sections, like these sections together, mm-hmm. and just sew them together.
And you're gonna see so many different looks. And as we go through and we show you samples and other things, you're gonna see some great other looks with this die as well.
Yeah.
Well, now that other die is the cross canoe die, right?
We happen to have one here in this.
We happen to.
Okay, so this one's actually on a 10 by 10 die board. So you need the Go Bigger, the studio cutter with the adapter.
That's right.
Use it. But the thing I love about this is it also makes a 9-inch finished block. So the other one was a 3x3 grid. This mm-hmm. is just a 4-patch. But all of the shapes are here just like in one section
yep.
of a block, right?
They sure are.
And A and A are, so you know which way to put it on the die. And then C goes right here. So what I've done, Erica, is I've just cut three colors.
Okay.
All right. I'm just going to put it right over here. Put them on a 10x10 mat. Use my Go Big. I just love this block.
And again, this is going to have a very different look than what Amanda did because she used a two color on the cross canoes.
Right.
You can do so much with these blocks as far as coloring them. So this one's got several colors in it. I think we're up to four on this one.
Yes, look at us doing math on the fly.
And on Amanda's, she had all the same background. She had the background color in here, so she really only had the two colors.
Yep, so we're just gonna build one real quick here in the corner. Because we can.
Because you can.
Yep. I need the other red. Look at this. And then let's put a blue in the middle.
And you can turn this block too, which is another interesting thing. So think about how different it would be on point. Then think how different it would be if you turn this to the outside. Again, all different look.
Yeah.
We're all about multitasking with our dies.
Look at that. Oh, see, now look, somebody's gonna say, Pam, you did that wrong, because I did. They always are good about catching it.
Yes, yes.
Yes, and then we'll put
keep
a blue.
Keep us honest. There you go.
Right?
Yeah.
So did we do that right?
We did.
No, we didn't, but
we
we'll
didn't.
Make it work.
No, flip another that one.
There we go.
There we go.
There we go, right there. No, this is the outside. This is why it was the wrong shape. This is why they're there.
Phew.
Good thing we
okay.
have it.
Okay.
So again, you're gonna lay out your block so all your pieces go correctly.
Yep.
And then you're gonna sew it together. So this is such a great die because you really can sew these blocks together super fast.
It really is, it yeah. really is.
Okay, now that we've made our fun little blocks here.
Perfect. Now next up, we're gonna meet with Gina to talk about her Crossroads design, right?
Yes, okay. She made this great design called Go to the Piazza, which is also available on our website today.
That's right. Well, welcome, Gina.
Hi, Gina.
There she is.
Hi, Erica.
Hello.
Hi, Pam.
How
are you?
Thanks for joining us today.
Oh, thanks for joining us. We're so excited to hear about your design. Now, where did you get the inspiration for your quilt?
Well, Pam and Erica, for me, it's all about love.
Look at how pretty it is.
When I first looked at the block, you can see that the corners have X's and you have an O that goes around the block. So it's all about the X's and the O's. Oh. And it's all about the love. And it just seems so fitting because it's about crossroads, and crossroads for us, life's crossroads are weddings, vacations, any of these special events. And, you know, people go to those weddings and they bring quilts. And yep. What do? They hug and they kiss. So that's my inspiration. It's all about love.
It's beautiful.
I love it.
All right, can you tell us about your design process and how you created this particular pattern?
Well, just like Amanda, I am a user of EQ8.
Good job.
I love electric quilt. I've been using it for years and years. But what drove this design process was, again, the theme of love. I kept thinking, I need to put X's and O's as the whole quilt.
Right.
And so that's where I went. I have the crossroads blocks as the X. Mm-hmm. And then I put an alternate block for the to make the O. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, I ended up thinking, well, crossroads block finishes to 9 inches. I have to use the 9-inch cube,
there
right?
There you go.
So that's how I came up with this, with that design, to use the 9-inch cube.
I love that.
It's beautiful. And do you have any pro tips on how to make this project?
Absolutely. I have two tips that I'd like to share. The first one is, it's so funny because I saw you struggling with that D and the E.
Right.
Right? So what I do is I cut like pieces of paper and I lay it out.
That's brilliant.
Oh, okay.
And so I know exactly where the C and the D are going and the E and how they're supposed to be put together.
There you go.
That is brilliant. So I love that.
This is a time saver.
Yeah.
Just a big time saver. So I love it. I do this for most of my blocks. That's mm-hmm. just so I know how they go.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, I love that.
And the other tip I had was, if you look at the quilt that I made, I do have units where instead of using the colored pieces, mm-hmm. the colored D and the, I have units where I have all white. And so I have a white D and two white E's to go. And it's a lot of piecing. So, yes. So to save time, because, you know, we got to go to quilting, right?
Right. Right.
To save time, I figured out that if you use a 2-inch finished half square triangle instead of the EDE unit,
yes.
It just works very well.
So shape number 5 from the 8-inch cube.
Yeah, the small half square triangle.
Yes. Oh.
Gina, you're a genius.
You're a genius. That's
Thank
brilliant.
You. It was fun figuring it out. And then I just got so excited because it's from the 8-inch cube, the 4-inch cube, and there's an independent die that does it.
There you go.
Oh my gosh, that is perfect. Well,
okay, I love that too.
I love that. Well, your quilt design is so great. Thank you so much for joining us today. I can't wait to go home and try that tip. I look forward to seeing more of your designs with us in the future.
Thanks, Gina, for
joining
us. Thank
you so much for having me.
You bet. Bye-bye.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Okay, first of all, the whole pasted down on paper.
Genius.
Genius. We always talk about making a test block.
Right.
But you could just do that so much faster.
Yeah, and then you have it. And like she said, she does that for all of her blocks. So what if you have like a file of all of those? So if you're doing something, you just pull it out and you're ready to go.
That's brilliant. And 2-inch square.
2-inch half square triangle. Gina, you're our new hero.
Okay.
Absolutely. All right. Well, I feel like there is something missing from our show, though, today, Pam.
What is that?
We haven't given away anything yet.
Oh, well, let's take care of that right now.
All right. We are going to give away 4 of our now permanent members of the die lineup, the Go Crossroads die.
All right, quilters, our first lucky winner of the Go Crossroads die is, drum roll, please. Mary S. from Lincoln, Nebraska. You're down the street.
I bet she's been to the quilt museum.
I bet she has. Ever since we had Halloween and we had the witch's cackle, mm-hmm. so I feel like we should have like semi-horns going doo, 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 instead of drum roll. Okay, go ahead. Your turn.
Okay. Our second winner of a Go Crossroads die is, drum roll, please, Anna S. from Portland, Oregon.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Anna.
You're going to love this stuff.
You are going to have so much fun.
Quilters, take 30% off your order when it comes to the code FUN30, F-U-N-3-0. Don't forget, our two Crossroad bundles are specially priced as well.
That's right. FUN30, because we're fun.
We are, and we're 30.
That's right. So remember that. Yeah. So pick up the Go Crossroads bundle for only $76.99 with that code FUN30, saving you over $32. Or make your quilting adventure complete with the Go Crossroads and Setting Triangle bundle for only $176.37. You totally want this.
Yeah.
It's going to save you over $75.
And quilters, if you already have the Go Crossroads die, first of all, share what you've made with us. We'd love
to see
it.
Yeah, we'd love to see it. Absolutely.
Everything you need for the holidays, you should grab today while they're in stock.
Yes.
Again, the code is FUN30 at checkout. Don't miss out.
All right, I loved how Gina used the 9-inch cube and companion angles in her project to create that whole new look.
All right, so let's take a look at the 9-inch cube. Ready?
Yep.
Ta-da, we pull it out.
There it is.
All right, Erica, here's a big pro tip. Why did we pull the skinny one first?
We pull it off so we don't break a nail, because we have lovely manicure, some of us, and we don't want to break a nail. But you don't, and so that's even more of a reason, because it's easier to break your nails.
It is. I'll work on that.
There you go.
What's in the skinny one that we pull out first?
A cutting mat, because nothing happens without a mat, but also a pattern booklet. It's great.
Yes. All right, so let's pull these out and show everybody what's there.
Yes, indeed. And we've got some samples of those shapes right over here.
We do.
My friend Pam used a pin on these.
I used a pin just for Erica.
I'm so proud.
Now, first of all, quilters, the shapes in the cube, we have six different sizes of cubes. 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, and 12.
Yeah, you made it all the way through.
Made it all the way through. All the shapes are the same in every cube. They're just different sizes.
That's right.
Okay, so the first thing to remember is that the cube system is based on a 4-patch system. So shape number one, I think you have a 4-patch.
I have a shape number one.
Is a square.
That's right.
In every cube, okay? 4 of these sewn together in this case makes a 9-inch finished block. So don't think, I'm getting the 9-inch cube. It has 9-inch blocks. There's sewing involved.
That's right. So we're going to keep this here so we can refer to it, because here's our shape number one you can see.
Shape number two and every cube are smaller squares, all right? So 4 of these sewn together is always going to equal back to shape number one.
That's right.
All right. Hey, that's oven mitt fabric.
It is oven mitt fabric.
Get you an oven mitt today. They're not on sale, but get you an oven mitt.
Oh, but you want that dye.
Yes. All right. Shape number three in every cube are half square triangles. So remember, quilters, all of our geometric shapes have that 1/4-inch seam allowance built in. And once we add triangles, we've cut off the dog ears. So from here to here is a perfect 1/4-inch seam.
That's right.
Okay.
And again, two of those together is going to be one of shape number one.
Yep. Shape number four in every cube are 1/4-square triangles, okay? Now, the thing to remember about 1/4-square triangles is they're 1/4-square triangles, not half-square triangles,
right?
Okay? So, what do you think, Erica? Tell them about how
it's
to remember.
It's all about your lengthwise grain. Yeah. So, if you look on your die, you want your lengthwise grain here. You want that on the outside of your block so that you're stable. You don't want it on the inside of the block.
Right.
So, again, you want your lengthwise grain on the outside of block to stabilize it. And 4 of shape number 4, make 1 of shape number 1.
All right, shape number 5 in every cube is our workhorse die. These are smaller half square triangles, and we're going to leave this one out because this is the one that Gina used.
Oh, yes, we need this one.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and so 8 of these sewn together equals shape number 1. Sometimes quilters say, there's so many of those shapes, I'm never going to use them.
Oh, but you need them so much.
Yeah.
You're going to use them so much.
It's our little workhorse.
That's right.
For example, you're going to need them here with shape number 6. Which is not just a square, but it is a square on point.
Now, we get asked a lot, Pam, about what's different between a square and a square on point.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really all about the math, because the square on point is designed to stand on its little tiptoe, like a ballet dancer, and have those shape number 5s fit on each side so that it creates a block that is the same size as shape number 1.
Right. So they measured the hypotenuse. And we didn't have to do it.
I shall take your word for that.
Yes.
I just know it works, and that's what I care about.
Now, shape number 7 in every cube are parallelograms.
That's right.
So the thing to remember about parallelograms is that they are a directional shape.
Oh, indeed they are.
So in our block there, we fan folded our fabric. Mm-hmm. So we had one parallel go one direction and the other parallelogram go the other direction. If you want your parallelograms to go the same direction, you want to just lay your fabric facing up.
That's right.
Okay, and then our last shape, I think, is also one Gina used, is shape 8. It is a rectangle.
Yep, okay? There we go.
So in every cube, these shapes are the same 8 shapes. They're just a different sizes.
Right, and look, okay. Two of them are going to make one of shape number 1, and you can see how one of these units is the same as the rectangle.
Yes, and I think she used shape number 8 as well.
Well, let's just pull that out just in case we need it.
All right, then we have the companion set angles. Here, I'm going to move this.
Okay.
So we have 2 companion sets, right? We have corners and angles.
Yes, and she used angles. So we're going to take a look at angles today.
Pull it up, say ta-da.
Ta-da. And what was our pro tip?
Pull the skinny one first so you don't break a nail.
There you go.
Okay. And it also has a mat and a pattern book in
That's
it.
That's right.
So unlike the original cube, which have 8 shapes, our companion sets only have 4.
That's right.
You need the original cube to make it work.
Right.
So the cube system, you get 144 mix and match blocks. Then every time you add a companion
72.
Set.
72. 72 with the original.
There we go.
72 more with each companion.
There we go. And then a total of 216.
There you go.
Look at us doing math on the fly.
It's not
easy. Those are free downloadable patterns at AccuQuilt.com. Okay, here we go. So here is the next set. So this is the companion set angles. So the first 2 shapes are these shapes, and they make the block Erica's going to show you right now. This is triangle in a square.
That's right.
So these half rectangles, the thing you want to, we're going to pull these as well. You want to fan fold your fabric back and forth on this die.
Because you need lefts and rights.
Yeah, otherwise you'll only get lefts and you'll be cranky about that.
That's right.
All right. And then here is the kite shape. Do I have one? Keep going.
Aha!
Sure. I knew we had some. So the kite shape also uses those half rectangles, right?
They're going to go on either side, and then those half rectangles will fit together as well.
They will, to make a rectangle.
To make a rectangle the same as our rectangle from our mix and match cube.
I love it. All right, and then the last shape, because Jack said, gosh, I hope there is a trapezoid.
And by golly,
there is.
There is.
So in order to make the trapezoid work, you need shape number 3 from the original cube, which is our big half square triangle,
right.
And our workhorse shape number 5.
Which again is the small one.
Yeah.
And then when you look at it, again, we've made something that is this equal to shape number 1, the large square, back in our mix and match cube.
Look at that. Ta-da, ta-da. All right, so those are the shapes in the cube and the companion set.
That's right.
Corners. All right.
Super.
Oh, angles. Sorry.
Angles.
All right, quilters, don't forget to register for our live events for the chance to win.
One of the door prizes, because we have 41 for all 3 of our shows coming up later this week, so don't forget.
Yes.
Plus, if you're not already following us on social media, you might be missing out on some AccuQuilt exciting announcements.
That's exactly right. We love to share your stories, quilts, and more.
That's right. Like, for instance, did you know that you can earn 250 reward points once a month that can be used to discount your future AccuQuilt purchases? Well, all you need to do is publicly share a picture of your quilting project, make it public, share it on social media using hashtag AccuQuiltBuilt.
Right, and then our team will mark in there that we've shared it.
That's right.
All right, we love seeing your skills and your projects, and there are lots of great reasons for you to join us on social media. We hope to see you there.
That's right, and if you're enjoying the inspiration in our show here, you really need to check out our blog if you haven't already. We always share projects for new dies there. We include tips, tricks. Don't miss the content. You won't find it anywhere else.
Yeah, there are patterns on our blog that you can only find on our blog.
Yep, special tutorials.
All right, so Erica, what inspires you most when it comes to quilting?
Oh, absolutely, hands down, it's the fabric. That's what got me started quilting in the first place, was a chance to use the fabric.
Okay, well, first of all, look at this.
It's so adorable. It's Jill's, and we want it so badly.
We do. Our good friends at, I know, it's like Christmas.
Magic.
Ta-da. Our good friends at Andover Fabrics are all about inspiration, and they want you to sew with the best. That is why they have provided us with this fabric to give away to a couple of lucky winners. So this fabric is more modern fabric.
Yes.
So look, it has great geometric shapes in it.
I love
the colors. Like this dark blue, cobalt blue. This could live so easily in
my stash. In your stash.
Uh-huh. And then talk about your...
This has a little bit more of a traditional feel to it, but it's almost like a tone-on-tone. You'll see it's got the same wonderful spriggy print, but it's almost going to act like... I mean, to me, this is going to be the perfect blender because I love a little movement in the blenders in my projects. And this has got such a wonderful fall palette. I love how the blues are working their way into the fall palette this year with patterns and things.
And so, I'm going to say I could make projects out of either one of these bundles.
And look how well it matches us, too.
I could find one to match.
We look lovely with today's fabric bundles.
All right, but Eric and I, we're going to give begrudgingly away
begrudgingly,
both of these,
we will.
Bundles. So the first winner of one of our fabric bundles is, drum roll, please. Sue L. from Pueblo, Colorado.
Oh, congratulations. All right, the second winner of a fabric bundle is, drum roll, please. Loma B. from Kerrville, Texas.
Congratulations, Loma.
Huge thank you to Andover Fabrics for sponsoring today's event and providing this really wonderful fabric. We appreciate it. We know our quilters do too.
All right.
I would have to put it away. Take it away from
our little hands.
Anxious little hands.
All right, quilters, if you want to know how your favorite fabrics will look in your finished projects, you need to check out GoQuilt. It's a free design tool on AccuQuilt's website that's loaded with hundreds of free patterns, fabric collections, and a rainbow of colors, but you can personalize it by adding your own fabric.
That's right.
Which you and I both have done.
We both have done. It's such a great tool. Pam and I use it all the time, like she said. Let's take a look at some sample blocks that we've made using the Go Crossroads die and how different they look.
Okay.
So this is like my first test block that I made.
Yes.
And I loved it.
I love it. It's just those three colors.
It's a little worse for the wear, you can see.
Yeah, it's been pressed quite a bit, but it looks great. All right, so Erica, you want to hold up this one?
So then here's another one, and this is done with the green. I'm going to hold it up because if I lay it down on our green mat, it's not going to pop out.
So really pretty for spring.
Really pretty for spring, St. Patrick's Day. It makes me think St. Patrick's Day.
So let's say you want to do something for Christmas.
Look how different it looks. It's got just a whole different look just by changing the colors. But as we saw, there are more different ways that you can change the color than I even showed you here.
Yeah, these are beautiful. All right, so think about that, quilters. What colors do you want to do it in?
That's right.
All right, now we know that Joy has been using
as
well to plan some holiday projects.
So, Joy, why don't you come on over, bring that quilt that you've been working on, because I love it.
Okay, so my daughter asked me to make a Christmas project for her, and I absolutely love this die. So this is
like all my favorite bobs together. I'm so happy.
Hey, first of all, it is Christmas fabric, right? Here
you
see the little Christmas minty stuff. But some grunge just for me.
Just for you.
Just for me. And tell us, Joy, what three dies did you use?
So these are all bobs. We have the Go Crossroads, we have the Go Churn Dash, and we also have the Glorified Nine Patch, which is...
So I had to look for a hot minute when you said that. I was like, there is no Glorified Nine Patch in these circles. This is Glorified Nine Patch. And Joy and I could live in the same room because we also love that white on white pattern. So basically she just took all of the center and made it one color.
Yep.
That is cool. And did you use GoQuilt to design this?
I didn't. Actually, I have to give a call out because Katie helped me with this. Katie and I, she is a design extraordinaire, and she helps everyone out in the comments.
She does.
And
she does.
When I asked her for some ideas, it started there, and then I kind of brought it to life. So she's my partner in crime.
She is great. She is a pro at using EQ8.
I know. I'm a little jealous.
Yeah, me too.
All right. Next we have... this beautiful quilt.
Wait, just a second.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
That's okay.
Yeah, no, I think we're good.
Yep. Are we good? Are we ready to go on?
Good.
Okay.
Yes.
So this one, now I know what I was supposed to remind you of, and it's very important. We don't have a pattern for that one. We love Joy's quilt. We don't have a pattern for it. That was inspiration only. Now we're moving to the section where we're going to have patterns for it. All right. So now we can go ahead.
Sorry, I threw a monkey wrench in all of that. I made a
note in my head, and it just needed to get out into the show.
So this is actually one of my very favorite versions. This is from Bia Lee. It's called Go Intersections Throw Quilt, and she used Michael Miller fabrics. Okay, one of the things I love about it is that it's such a modern color, right? The black and the white and the gray. I just feel like it's such a great movement. It reminds me of the map for the Linden Tube.
Which, ever since you said that, it's all I can see when I look at it.
Glad, thanks.
And I just love it for that very reason.
Yeah. And Joy, what did you love about this?
I love the quilting on it. The geometric shapes of the crossroads with the swirls and the quilting. I just love that combination.
Right. And I can tell you, I don't often make quilts that are solids. But more and more, I'm seeing more solids.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
Well, and I like how she pulled that corner block to make the corner stones in the quilt with that cross.
Right.
Really like having that little X.
Sashing in there.
Love it.
Yeah.
Very cool.
That is fun.
Next one is this quilt that we talked about a little bit earlier.
Yes, this is from our good friend Amanda Harward of Larkspur Quilts in its Timeless Treasure fabric.
That's right.
It's just beautiful. I love the way that she switched the block up just by moving one color throughout, and it just gives it such a different look. You almost wouldn't even know it's the same block. Mm-hmm. So you're getting that versatility when you use this dye.
And I do love it's only three colors.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right? And again, solids. So.
And how that cross canoe plays with it, and they meet at that intersection.
The corners are just beautiful. I can't imagine trying to do that without the bob dyes.
Oh, gosh, no.
Oh, it just, but they come together so absolutely beautifully there. I just love it.
Good job, Amanda.
Absolutely.
Thank you. All right, next up, we've got our Go Roundabout Throw Quilt. And this was designed by Kelly Marshall of Simply Macbeth Designs. And this one's on the package, I believe.
Yes, it is.
The dye.
Pattern on the packaging.
And this is just the Crossroads dye.
Mm-hmm.
This is all the one block. It's those fun sherbety colors.
Yep.
But I love how it pops that stripe binding.
Okay, 2022, all of my quilts are going to have stripe binding.
I'm going to hold you to that.
It's my new thing. But I love the fact that she also used those fun little blocks in the corner. You know, she just lined them up perfectly. Right.
But it gives it a whole different look when you put them together side by side, doesn't it?
Really it really does. Yeah, it's awesome. And then I have to share this. We talked about this a little bit earlier. The beautiful fabric that she has on the binding almost mimics the block.
It looks like Crossroads.
It's awesome.
I love that.
Just love it.
Good job.
All right, now this is Gina's quilt that we love so much. This is Go to the Piazza. And it's a throw quilt by Gina Jempasaw of Gem Hill Quilts. And she used Hoffman fabrics on this one.
Okay, first of all, any quilt that has the word piazza in it is going to be
we love.
Wrong. You can't go wrong.
That's right.
You can't go wrong. So let's show her, Erica, where she used the 2-inch squares.
Yes.
Right here.
Right there. Yep.
2-inch half square triangles. So instead of cutting all three shapes out of white, she just used it right here to create these corner sections.
That's right.
And then you don't see the outer edge of the crossroads.
You don't. And here's that triangle and a square right here.
Right.
You can see it. We've got those sides. And that gorgeous Hoffman batik really accenting it.
And it's kind of like a medallion quilt, right? You have that medallion in the center.
It does. That is the feel of it.
Yeah, it is. Right? And again, she's pulled that corner piece out to put that X up as a cornerstone.
Yeah.
And it really
I gotta remember
pulls your eye to the center. Yeah. I would not have thought of that. And it's such a natural, it just flows so well.
Yeah, and great quilting on it. Good job, Gina.
Next up, we've got the Go Crossroad Woven Garden Quilt. There we go. This is by Ellen Alt of Handmade 3D. And again, this is just that one block.
Right.
And just like the earlier one, but such a different look based on the fabric choices.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and these colors are really popular right now, right? With this little hint of gold in it and then the gold binding. Okay, I love fabric that has words on it.
Yes. So
this has all fun little words like L.M. Montgomery and all sorts of little sayings and stuff on it.
but a beautiful, fast project you could make.
And she's taken that center block and substituted it with the corner block, and it changes it out.
Oh, how many times have I looked at this quilt and never known that?
I just did the same thing. You're right. I love it. Yeah. Again, the versatility. I just love it.
It's fabulous.
That's fabulous.
I have some of that floral at home. I worked it into a Halloween quilt, if you can believe that.
Hey, Eric, will you hold the end?
Oh, yes.
Turn it this way.
Yes.
So this is Rolling Rings quilt. Our good friend Melanie Call of A Bit of Scrap Stuff. She used Moda fabric. Moda, it's not just for grunge.
Look at this, it's got scissors and the pins.
I love the pin drop fabric.
Yeah, the pin drop fabric, it's cute. And then look, these are like little hand stitched.
But it flows from the pinky peachy tones into the blues, I love that.
It's like the ombre look.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and blue is big popular right now. This kind of shades of peach and blues and pinks. And
very
stuff.
Popular.
Very popular, and a stripe binding.
A stripe binding, this is a bias stripe too.
Yeah,
it is.
Love it, and look, she put the scissors on the back too.
So cute.
Love it.
We're quilters. We have to look at everything.
The fabric,
front, the back. We gotta go through the whole thing. All right. This one is Go Kisses of Color Throw Quilt. This is new by Gina Jempsaw of Gem Hill Quilts. And again, Hoffman Fabrics. I love this one so much.
Beautiful.
So this is the same one where she's replaced this block with just half square triangles that are solid.
Right.
And I love the batiks in it. It's so pretty.
And separated it out so that you don't have that secondary circle. You just have the outer. And really, I think that gray kind of grounds it, and then the colors just sing. They're so saturated.
So I would assume this this is a 3.5-inch finished to 3-inch strip,
mm-hmm.
right? Because these finished to 3. Mm-hmm. I bet they're on sale today. Use that code FUN30 and see if you can
check
get
it out.
Strip. Yeah, because this is so pretty.
That'd be a 3-inch finished strip.
Yes.
Yes.
Cuts 3.5-inch strip.
I love that. The blue binding sets it off. It's just like a little frame for it.
It is. I have some of this fabric in my stash at home, actually.
We just recognize it. All right. All these projects really make me want to pull out my Crossroads die again and start designing something new.
You should.
Look
it's
what
an
you did
easy
to me.
Block to
what
work
you
with.
Did to me.
And Erica, you and I are kindred spirits when it comes to pinning.
Yes,
but
they are.
I was just blown away when I did this particular block and how little time I had to take to pin everything together because it just went together so
smoothly. Did.
You'd think with the smaller pieces it wouldn't work that way, but it really does. The corners come together just perfectly. This one quickly became my favorite.
Your
Bob
favorite, Bob.
I just love it. I love it.
All right, quilters, remember you can use the Go Quilt with any of the patterns we showed you today.
Thank you so much for having me back, ladies. I really enjoyed talking about all of these incredible quilts with you, and I look forward to our next trunk show together.
All right, thanks so much.
Anytime you design anything that fun, you can come back.
Yeah, just come back. It was okay. I loved her quilt.
I did too.
And Glorified Nine Patch, one of my favorite Bob dyes.
Oh, me too.
But I never think of just making it white.
No, but she didn't. And some of them were white, all white. Some of them were the four.
Just goes on. All right, quilters, remember you can get today your Crossroads bundle for only $76.99 or make your quilting adventure complete with this bundle of the Go Crossroads and the Setting Triangles for $176.37. Boy, that is some math right there.
That is, and we didn't have to do it.
Yep. Be sure to use the promo code FUN30, F-U-N-3-0 at checkout to receive the special offer and order now before our bundles run out. So currently, Erica, we have all of these products
Yep, we've
our
got
warehouse.
Those in stock, but we can see running out of those Crossroads dyes because they're so wonderful.
Yeah.
So be sure to get your order in. Now, don't forget that you can also get 30% off of some other items in your order as well, like that cross canoe dye that we talked about. And Amanda used it in her pattern. If you ordered it today with the code FUN30, it would only be $41.99. And you know some exceptions are going to apply, so be sure to check your website for details. Now, like we mentioned before, the Go Big that we used, it's not 30% off, but it is $150 off if you use the code BIG150. It saves you $150, so be sure to use that code.
And if you live in the contiguous U.S., it will ship free.
That is correct.
Now, quilters, our 9-inch cubes aren't part of that promo 30, but it's already special priced on our website.
Oh, well, there you go.
So just check out some other deals.
All right.
Quilters, use your phone's camera to capture this QR image here. It'll take you directly to the bundle.
If you don't have access to a QR reader, just open a new tab in your browser, type in AccuQuilt.com/party, and you'll see those bundles.
Don't forget that all these great deals end tonight at 12 midnight Central
Time.
Like Cinderella. Quilt now and pay later. Visit AccuQuilt.com/financing to learn more.
All right, quilters, we're about to give away our final prizes for the day.
That's wonderful. Two more Go Crossroads dies. We'll be traveling to a new home.
Thanks, Jack.
All right.
Our third winner of a Go Crossroads die is, drum roll please, Rachel H. from
Orem,
Utah.
There we go. Congratulations.
I thought so, but I just wanted to check.
And our final winner of the day is, drum roll please, Pamela W. from New Albany, Ohio. Congratulations. Congratulations to all of our winners. Hey, be sure to share your finished projects with us
on
our social media. We'd love to see it, and you can earn reward points.
That's right.
All right, quilters, you might not know this, but typically we are at Quilt Festival in Houston at this time of year with our entire team.
Yes.
But this year we are staying home, but we decided to bring the fun of festival to your living room for three more new shows this week. We're adding all the finishing touches to our celebrations. So tomorrow's AQ Live, we are going to share the Arkansas Traveler die.
Yes.
I love that die.
It's a fan favorite show.
Yep. It's at 12 noon Central Time. And it's a recorded show, so I'm going to join you live in the comments section. So if there's questions you have for me, I'll be in the comments section answering those questions. And I'm going to have hot chocolate and cookies.
Should I come on and ask you difficult questions?
Please do. Please do.
Then join us back here, right here, Thursday, October 28th at 12 noon Central Time. We're going to give you a sneak peek into our next new die that releases the following Tuesday.
I love it.
I do too. It's really fun.
I love it. And
you can order it.
You can order them on Thursday. The real release, Tuesday.
Tuesday.
We don't care.
Order early.
Friday, we've invited fabric manufacturers to share an inside view of what's new and what's coming with fabric. Quilters,
so
you
excited.
Will just love this
Such
show.
Such great fabrics.
Such love.
You're going to love it. And finally, on Saturday, we've got some quilting celebrities, including Eleanor Burns,
Yay.
Alex Anderson, Yay. And Aditya Sitar,
Yay.
Sharing what they've been up to, what's coming up for them, and more. You're not going to want to miss out on a minute. And you know, we're going to have some great prizes. Can you say fabric?
Fabric.
Fabric.
Our favorite.
It makes us smile.
All right, check out the AccuQuilt event page to register for each show. Now, quilters, when you register for an event, you will be entered to win a door prize for that show.
Mm-hmm.
And we randomly draw winners for each giveaway. But you have to register to win.
Right.
And in addition, for those three shows, we're going to give you one entry per show towards, listen to this, Erica.
I know.
$500 in reward point giveaway to be used in a future purchase.
That's right.
Register for all 3 days so you have three chances to win, not only every day, but $500.
But the $500 in reward point.
It's a no-brainer.
Now, be sure to sign up to be an AQ Circle member and get exclusive emails while you're on our website. These emails provide you with exciting information like new shows and so much more. To sign up, visit AccuQuilt.com/AQCircle.
All right, quilters, today has been such a fun day, but it's time for us to wrap up our event. We hope that you are as excited as we are about the creative possibilities with our Go Crossroads die.
Now, if you're new to AccuQuilt, then be sure to stay after the credits for some useful information about our fabric cutters.
All right, quilters, thanks again for joining us today. I'll see you tomorrow, and Erica and I will see you Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. For our three-day festival celebration.
That's right. Now, if you've been waiting for the show to end before you buy, now's that time. Here's the link. We want you to make sure that you get your deals before they sell out.
And remember, at AccuQuilt, we help you cut time.
So you can quilt more.
Goodbye.
See you soon.